Are you serious? Are you serious? All right, folks, they have him in custody now. Ryan Garreau. Ryan Garreau in the Mesa, Arizona shooting spree. He was an ex-convict with a history of violence and drug use. He's accused of gunning down a man in a Mesa, Arizona motel Wednesday morning, then going on a shooting spree that left five others, including a student, injured. The Mesa SWAT team took Ryan Garreau, age 41, into custody about 1 p.m. local time there in Mesa in a vacant condominium near Longmore Avenue after a massive manhunt that included four other law enforcement agencies. And we covered it live during our live broadcast yesterday, especially in the last hour or so. We went live with several updates. If you can watch my broadcast at my website, if you want to go to the live channel page, go to my website, and then right there you can click on the archive and watch the entire program. Garreau was shot with a taser, taken to Banner Desert Medical Center in Mesa for treatment, and then questioned late Wednesday evening by detectives and investigators. He was expected to be booked on murder charges this morning. The violence began shortly after 8 a.m. at the Tri-City Motel. When there, he shot one man and killed him and shot two other women. He fled the scene, running across the street to a bistro where he shot a culinary student. The dead man that he killed at the Tri-City Motel was David Williams, age 29, who lived at the motel. After shooting another man at the bistro, he then carjacked a car and took it to a apartment complex where he shot another man. Then fleeing on foot to the apartment complex next door, he shot another man. Now, this was an incredible situation where he ended up shooting six people and one is dead. It was a very fluid scene. We kept getting information. I'll give you a picture of him here. But that is him. This guy's been in and out of prison several times. A very violent individual who snapped yesterday. And here's why I bring this up about the fact that there's yesterday was a very wicked day. You had this situation in Mesa, Arizona, but you also had the radical Islamic Muslim militants in Tunisia gunning down tourists as they got off the tourist bus entering into a museum. And they ultimately killed 19 people. Most of them were from foreign countries like England, France, European nations. But they killed 19 innocent people before they themselves were shot dead. So it's a horrific bloodbath that took place in Tunisia, as well as a chaotic scene. And yesterday when I was on the air, I kept saying there is just no way one guy could have done all of this by himself. I was convinced there had to be two, three, four. And that really made me concerned that we had an absolute potential for a martial law type meltdown in Mesa, Arizona. But I was wrong. One guy, superhuman type abilities, chaos, chaotic, careless, just completely out of control, as demon spirits were literally being like, all restraints were let go yesterday. And you could go, if a person had the opportunity to actually check the records around the globe, it would have been insane what's going on. But of course, the CERN is in the process of being fired up. It's not even reached its potential. We're expecting it to maybe come very close to that. We're expecting protons to be colliding tomorrow, March the 20th, on the spring equinox, on a total eclipse of the sun. there will be, without question, a high intensity. Will the portals of hell open? Will the Illuminati release Apollyon? Or has he already been released? Or is that yet to come? Well, there's seven craters that's opened up out of the earth. I would lean more toward the seven craters in Russia as releasing the demon spirits from the bottomless pit, which is so unexplained. But no question, the CERN is involved in scrambling, releasing, manipulating the frontal lobes of many people and releasing the demon spirits that are already prevalent in the world. So we'll continue to keep an eye on that. That's tomorrow. Today, don't miss my live broadcast. We'll talk about this, but we're going to talk about, we're going to have our guest today will be Katie Wick. Katie Wick. Now, Katie Wick covered the Jody Arias trial there in Phoenix, Arizona. She went every day to the trial. She was on the Dr. Drew show, and she was even one of his jurors. Katie's been following my ministry since the first days I started on YouTube. I had less than 50 subscribers. But in her own right now, she has begun to really, God, I think, strategically put her there to follow this case. We're going to get some of the very, I want to know more about the demeanor in the courtroom, not only by Jody, but the family members, the jury. Everybody involved. We're going to get some of that inside information today on our live broadcast. But Katie Wick is more than just that. She is almost an attorney. She is studying to be an attorney very close now. And also, she believes in standing up for the Constitution of the United States. And like I said, she just appeared recently on Dr. Drew back in October. And we look forward to having her on our broadcast. Katie Wick will be our guest. We'll talk about all of these things that are happening in these last days. Certainly America needs somebody to stand up for our constitutional rights, as it seems like the spirit of darkness is hovering over the land. I'll be praying. Give your life to Jesus Christ. We're running out of time. Are you serious? We are running out of time.